Special Reports is a daily show that will cover issues surrounding the economic collapse. All our reports and daily alert news are backed up by source links. We work very hard to bring you the facts, and we research everything before presenting the report. Subscribe for latest on financial crisis, oil price, global economic collapse, dollar collapse, gold, silver, Bitcoin, global reset, new world order, economic collapse, economic news, political, geopolitical news. Today, we talk about global currency reset and predicate to an inexorable global monetary based on gold. A North Korean conflict could be precedent-setting for a new global doctrine for the militarization of belligerent nuclear threats. Sanctions on North Korea probably will not work, and the U.S. might ultimately occupy the same until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. China logically might occupy India, presumably invoking the newly established belligerent nuclear threats doctrine. India has very large above-ground/mine reserves of physical gold, second perhaps only to China. The knock-on effect of China occupying India will be to block U.S. access to gold that might help defend the U.S. from being deposed as the global reserve currency. Geopolitical issues have ripened to the point where it is possible to theoretically foresee and more clearly bring into focus a specific related potential global monetary and reserve currency reset scenario. Seeking Alpha is replete with commentary articulating various macroeconomic permutations and nuances of unsound monetary policies and the damaging effects of easy money and fiat currencies. What has been absent and frustrating is the lack of a trigger event that can be used to hypothesize and explain how years of unsound money policies might start to unwind. Now there appears to be a real near-term factual predicate based on geopolitical risk that could reverse the destructive positive feedback loop reflexivity of an easy money Fed-induced and enforced planned economy and by extension, globally. Unfortunately, a new reverse positive feedback loop reflexivity triggered by geopolitical events will not simply, harmlessly and painlessly reverse years of misguided failed Fed monetary experiments. The effect of unwinding years of injected toxic debased currency into the economy will be that the new reverse positive feedback loop will drastically deflate asset values and result in a very painful period of realignment of expectations. The extant moribund volatility of financial asset markets is finally now responding to the imminent risks presented by unfolding geopolitical events. Tensions have escalated in view of North Korea's overt belligerent nuclear threats directed specifically at the U.S. The world may have reached the tipping point regarding belligerent nuclear threats, and a kicking the can down the road approach may no longer be acceptable. If sanctions against North Korea do not work, then one way or another the U.S. may be forced to act preemptively. One scenario probably includes occupation of North Korea until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. U.S. action and occupation of North Korea could create a new global belligerent nuclear threats doctrine that could be relied upon by another country as justification to take preemptive action. Namely, China can use the newly minted belligerent nuclear threats doctrine and characterize India as a belligerent nuclear threats and thereby justify occupation of India until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. Tensions between India and China are already on the rise. India is important because it has one of the largest above-ground/mined physical gold reserves in the world, which might be second only to China's reserves. It is estimated that India may have 20,000 tons of gold held by its citizens. The Indian government has only a relatively meager amount of reported gold reserves. If China ultimately anticipates a global reserve currency reset, away from the U.S., it might want to lock up the physical gold reserves held in India and therefore block the U.S. from potentially accessing the same. For example, the U.S. might want to access the large stockpile of Indian gold via an asset swap mechanism or some other approach in order to help defend the U.S. when ultimately China proceeds with backing the yuan with China's estimated 36,000 plus tons of physical gold estimated combined citizen and government reserves. Please refer to Daily Coin, Alas Dear MacLeod, Gold is Money, and In-Depth Review, August 9, 2017, for a more detailed discussion of estimated physical gold reserve tonnage for India and China. Obviously, such a scenario assumes that Indian citizens' property rights in physical gold will be trampled. Expropriation and redistribution of wealth by sovereign authorities has occurred in the past and will occur in the future, and is well known in the US. There's no reason to believe that Indian citizens will necessarily have a safe store of value in privately held gold, and that it will not be appropriated by either the Indian government or appropriated directly or indirectly by some other sovereign authority, but I digress. In any case, a launch of a gold-backed yuan currency would potentially euthanize most fiat currencies and render impotent the current paradigm of Fed and other central bank money printing. Unfolding geopolitical issues may be the sharp needle that pricks the financial asset bubbles that have been blown by global central bank money printing. Geopolitical events may set in motion a new positive feedback loop, reflexivity, that will quickly deflate financial asset valuations that will overwhelm any potential Fed attempts to kick the can down the road again with more easy money. The Fed lowering interest rates to zero or slash and more money printing is not going to demilitarize belligerent North Korea or defuse the extant geopolitical crisis. Fed monetary policy will not be able to stop or prevent the inevitable boom-bust cycle from running its course, as predicted by Austrian economic theory. Crucial to understanding the nuances of Austrian economic theory is understanding the destructive power of easy money. The obvious effect of easy money has been to hyperinflate financial assets without creating real wealth. Eventually, the inflation currently slash temporarily locked into the financial markets will be redistributed into the main street economy via consumer price inflation. The redistribution of easy money inflationary effect can be delayed or obscured temporarily by the Fed, but cannot be avoided longer term. The inevitable hyperstagflation that will come cannot be avoided because there is no mechanism for the Fed to reverse decades of damaging monetary policy that has promoted unproductive consumption, created large-scale dependence from unproductive elements in the economy, and debased the use beyond repair via the Fed money printing. The Fed may not understand yet that it is powerless to stop a potential near-term monetary and currency reset that might be triggered by unfolding geopolitical conflicts. And therefore, the Fed may attempt to implement yet more misguided damaging monetary policy that will expedite the debasement of the use and accelerate the boom-to-bust economic crisis. Fed actions have and probably will continue to set the stage for China to step in and float a gold-backed yuan currency that inexorably will depose the yuan as the global reserve currency. If the US goes into North Korea, then China might go into India, and thereby lock up gold reserves and ultimately seal the fate of the yuan as a former global reserve currency, while at the same time establishing a new era belligerent nuclear threat doctrine and setting the stage for a global monetary and currency reset based on a gold-backed yuan. Are we going to see a global currency reset? The case for something like a global currency reset is interesting, and harks back to the darkest financial days of recent times. In 2008, as the world economy was teetering on the edge of the abyss, thoughts were moving towards how this situation could have occurred and how to prevent this occurrence in the future. Recently I read an article discussing the inevitability of a global currency reevaluation and reset. For most observers and even many traders, the first question that comes to mind is not the merits or failings of such an issue, but something much more fundamental: what is a global currency reset? There is a reason that most people are not familiar with the concept. That is because it is something that has rarely been used in recent history. Only once in the last 100 years, after World War II, with the fear of another Great Depression in the air and the note of conciliation in the collective minds of politicians the world over, at the famous Bretton Woods Conference, was this achieved. It was effective in preventing another depression, and in fact, the years post-World War II saw strong economic recovery as the world recovered from its wartime slump and industry exploded. It was also a unique confluence of circumstances. The world had been decimated by war, and countries had come together collectively to fight a common enemy. It was the last time that much of the world had stopped thinking exclusively about sovereign interests and banded together for international goals. The lives of foreign nationals became important, and armies fought for and protected the lands of their neighbors. Politicians had become used to thinking about the interests of their allies. This alone made it a unique time in history for collaborative action and collaborative will. The reason this is relevant is because a global currency reset is where all the nations, or at least a vast majority, agree to one currency standard, like gold, for example. The critical factor is agreement between countries, which is only ever achieved when the needs and interests of those countries are aligned. The case for something like a global currency reset is interesting, and harks back to the darkest financial days of recent times. In 2008, as the world economy was teetering on the edge of the abyss, thoughts were moving towards how this situation could have occurred and how to prevent this occurrence in the future. The leaders of the world wanted to create a situation where irresponsible activities in another country did not destroy their economy. Post-Bretton Woods, the main reserve currency held by countries was the US dollar, yet another reason that worldwide financial issues were so encompassing. Would a reset be the solution? Ultimately, the world did not go that way. Post-World War II was a unique time, where not only was there a global consensus, but also mutual interest. Post-2008, the mutual interest was lacking. The simple fact that some countries would have benefited less from a global reset, meant that it would take significant political will to undermine this element. To surrender control of monetary policy because of the failures of another country would be unthinkable politically. Resets would limit the ability of central banks, a major point of friction that is playing out in Europe. Not to mention the fighting that would arise amongst countries trying to set the new standard. Just think of the varying positions and interests of Russia, China and the USA, and you can imagine how easily this would be solved. Is the world likely to see another global currency reset? Honestly, it would take a worldwide disaster against North Korea do not work then one way or another the US may be forced to act preemptively. One scenario probably includes occupation of North Korea until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. US action and occupation of North Korea could create a new global belligerent nuclear threats doctrine that could be relied upon by another country as justification to take preemptive action. Namely, China can use the newly minted belligerent nuclear threats doctrine, and characterize India as a belligerent nuclear threats and thereby justify occupation of India until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. Tensions between India and China are already on the rise. India is important because it has one of the largest above-ground/mined physical gold reserves in the world, which might be second only to geopolitical news. Today, we talk about global currency reset and predicate to an inexorable global monetary based on gold. A North Korean conflict could be precedent setting for a new global doctrine for the militarization of belligerent nuclear threats. Sanctions on North Korea probably will not work and the US might ultimately occupy the same until the belligerent nuclear threats is made safe. China logically might occupy India, presumably invoking the newly established belligerent nuclear threats doctrine. India has very large above-ground/mine reserves of physical gold, second perhaps only to China. The knock-on effect of China occupying India will be to block US access to gold that might help defend the US from being deposed as the global reserve currency. Geopolitical issues have ripened to the point where it is possible to theoretically foresee and more clearly bring into focus a specific related potential global monetary and reserve currency reset scenario. Seeking Alpha is replete with commentary articulating various macroeconomic permutations and nuances of unsound monetary policies and the damaging effects of easy money and fiat currencies. What has been absent and frustrating is the lack of a trigger event that can be used to hypothesize and explain how years of unsound money policies might start to unwind. Now there appears to be a real near-term factual predicate based on geopolitical risk that could reverse the destructive positive feedback loop reflexivity of an easy money Fed-induced and enforced planned economy and by extension, globally. Unfortunately, a new reverse positive feedback loop reflexivity triggered by geopolitical events will not simply, harmlessly and painlessly reverse years of misguided failed Fed monetary experiments. The effect of unwinding years of injected toxic debased currency into the economy will be that the new reverse positive feedback loop will drastically deflate asset values and result in a very painful period of realignment of expectations. The extant moribund volatility of financial asset markets is finally now responding to the imminent risks presented by unfolding geopolitical events. Tensions have escalated in view of North Korea's overt belligerent nuclear threats directed specifically at the US. The world may have reached the tipping point regarding belligerent nuclear threats, and a kicking the can down the road approach may no longer be acceptable. If sanctions Special Reports is a daily show that will cover issues surrounding the economic collapse. All our reports and daily alert news are backed up by source links. We work very hard to bring you the facts, and we research everything before presenting the report. Subscribe for latest on financial crisis, oil price, global economic collapse, dollar collapse, gold, silver, Bitcoin, global reset, new world order, economic collapse, economic news, political.